is News at 11.
And your big story at 11, answering your questions about the story of the day, Logan Hetherington's unique hit-and-run plea deal.
Why so short? Why so lenient? Why possibly no prison? Hi, I'm Krista Fogelsong.
I'm Jeff Butera. Today, the 20-year-old was sentenced to 2 years as a youth offender for hitting and killing 8-year-old Layla Aiken at her Cape Coral bus stop and never stopping. Layla's family signed off on that plea deal.
I'm angry, but I'm a mother. And I don't see an evil man when I look at Logan. I see a scared young man who made stupid, selfish choices, as teenagers are known to do.
It's now up to the Department of Corrections to decide whether he'll spend 2 years in prison or at a boot camp for young offenders. Since his sentencing, we've seen outrage on social media over what some are calling a slap on the wrist.
People are also asking, what even is a youthful offender program, and does a 20-year-old qualify for it? Our Jeff Harris is live in studio tonight getting you your answers.
Hey, Jeff and Krista. In the state of Florida, there are currently 10 active youthful offender facilities. As a youthful offender, your sentence cannot exceed 6 years, but it can be a combination of prison, community service, and probation. This is exactly what Logan Hetherington is now facing.
I don't see an evil man when I look at Logan. I see a scared young man who made stupid, selfish choices, as teenagers are known to do.
Logan Hetherington stood and listened as the mother of Layla Aiken spoke with grace and the judge delivered his sentence.
Your sentence will be that of a youthful offender, as indicated by the state attorney's office. You do appear to qualify for that sentence under the...
Hetherington qualifies for the youthful offender program for 3 reasons. The first two, he is under the age of 21 and has never been charged with a felony that would carry a sentence of life in prison or the death penalty.
Box number 3 is whether or not the defendant has ever been designated a youthful offender previously. Well, it doesn't sound like Mr. Hetherington ever has before, so he did check all 3 boxes in order for him to be designated a youthful offender.
Under the guilty plea Hetherington made, he is only required to serve 24 months behind bars, far less than if he were convicted by a jury.
We know it is a very strong likelihood that he would have been doing more than 10.3 years in prison should he have gone to trial and lost.
Hetherington's team pushed for those 2 years to be spent in a boot camp setting.
Phrase that I have heard consistently from those clients is that this boot camp is more of a gladiator camp than anything else.
So what can Hetherington expect?
A bunch of young guys full of testosterone with nothing better to do than take out their aggression on one another.
Final say on that is up to the Department of Corrections once Hetherington arrives. And when Hetherington is released, he'll walk out of jail a convicted felon, a label that will stay with him for life.
He's going to have a tough cross to bear, but he's alive, he's breathing, he's walking, he can have a family, he can make a living, he can bring joy in other people's lives as well as his own, which unfortunately, with the tragedy that took place, that can't be said the same for the victim.
Hetherington will also have to do 2 years of community service, followed by an additional 2 years of probation, a deal only made possible because of Layla Aiken's family.
Justice we are seeking for today is for her, not our anger. Therefore, there is no room for vengeance, anger, or hate. They have nothing to do with Layla.
Now, keep in mind, Hetherington will also have his driver's license suspended for 1 year. Many asked why just a year. Dunford tells us the decision is not up to the court, but rather the Department of Highway Safety Motor Vehicles. Live in studio tonight, Jeff Harris, ABC 7.